Hi folks, it's Mike White with X-Cart Guru. Well, I'm coming to you with another tutorial, and this one is for X-Cart 5. And we are going to be developing a theme in X-Cart 5, or a skin, or a template, whatever you want to call it. But we're going to build a custom theme from scratch, and just show you how to set up the theme and make a couple of changes within your new skin. So, I was embarking on a new journey for myself, where I was going to build a new theme for sale in the X-Cart marketplace. And I just thought, well, before I get too far into this, let's stop and let's show everybody how easy it is to get started with a new theme or skin for X-Cart 5. All right, let's get right into it. In X-Cart 5, a skin or a template is just a module that's been installed to the store. So we're going to be creating a module that's going to define our skin and define our skin directory. So that we can start putting templates in it and affecting the way X-Cart looks. So I'm in my Sublime Text Editor, and I have navigated to the directory that I'm working in. I have a local installation of X-Cart at XC515 mods here, and I'm inside the classes directory, inside XLite, inside module, and inside my developer ID. If you're building this for yourself, it doesn't matter what you use for your developer ID. Just pick a four-letter, word of some sort, and use that. So you would want to just create a new folder right here in modules, or in module. If you're a developer and you're looking to sell your skin in the marketplace, you just want to go to my.x-cart.com and create an account, and then contact developers@x-cart.com. And drop them a line and tell them that you want to be assigned a developer ID, and then you would use that in building your module. So once you have your developer ID figured out, mine is Guru with a capital G, you want to come up with the name for your module, and it's going to be a run-on sequence of words, or just one single phrase there. In my case, I'm calling my new theme Magnifico, because I really like the sound of that. Okay, so I only have two files created so far in my Magnifico directory. I have icon.png, and that, as you guessed it, that's the icon the module is going to be displayed with in the X-Cart 5 admin area. And then I have main.php. This is the most important file in any module, as it initiates the module and defines all of its settings. So I have just finished creating this main.php file. And it is, like I said, the only file in the module so far. So we're going to run through the code and explain what each part does. So here in line 30, we have a namespace. So that is pretty obvious. It's going to be where the file is actually located, where the module is located. So it's always XLite, and then module, and then your developer ID, mine's Guru, and then the module name. Okay, and so initially we just start out the class. Main, extends, XLite, module, a module. This is all typical code. It'll always look like that. Here's where we start making some changes. So we have author name. And, I'll post a sample code up on xcartguru.com just so you have this to start with, and you don't have to write all this out. But any module that you look at inside XC5 is going to have this code that you can just copy. So author name, again, it doesn't really matter if you're building it for yourself, but if you are a registered developer, it needs to be your proper author name or your module won't be accepted. And then the module name. So here we can spell it out and put spaces. This is what will show up in the admin section when they see the list of modules. So I put Magnifico responsive theme. All right, a description. So here's just a brief one-line description of what your module is about. And here's some important stuff. Right now, we're in the 5.1.x branch of X-Cart. So this will work with anything that's 5.1.0 or above, but it won't work with 5.1.2. So, it won't work with 5.2. So you're going to have to change this. When 5.2 is released, I'm going to have to go in and update my module and check it to see if it works with the new version, but also, change this to 5.2. So you set that to whatever the current version is that you're developing in. And the minor version of this module is 0. It's the first release. It's not an update or anything like that. Now we have a public static function show settings form, return true. So that is going to show a settings form in the admin next to the module. And I do plan on having some settings for my theme because I'm commercially releasing this. For a lot of you that are building this for yourself and your own site, I just set that to false. Okay, register the module skins. Here's the important part. We have to get the skins. And so we're just returning the array. Xlight customer interface, we're letting them know this is for the customer side. And Magnifico customer. So we would put admin interface if that was the, if we were trying to affect the admin side. But we're mostly probably going to be working with the customer side. So that's all I'm going to be using here at this point. I may need to modify it later. So just as it indicates here, there's going to be a new skin directory at Magnifico/customer. And it's going to overwrite this default EN customer directory. So let's look at that structure real quick. I think we need to create that folder. So we look in skins. And just to show you, we have default EN, and then we have all the skins that determine the customer side right now. So we're going to close that, and we're going to create a new directory, a new folder in skins. We're going to call it Magnifico, and hit enter. And then inside Magnifico, we're going to create a new folder, and we're going to call that customer, just as we've indicated here in the script. Okay, so now we have Magnifico and customer inside skins, and it's just empty. Now here, this is kind of an optional thing. I don't know that I'll even need this, but I've got the code already pasted in here just in case. This is a decorator method that runs after all the cache is built, and it can remove classes from lists. So I'm not going to go over that. We're not actually using that at this point. I have just put that in here so that I'm ready, if in case I do want to remove some classes from lists or remove some different templates from lists. So this is all that it takes to create the basic skin. That's why I was so excited to show this to you guys. The skin should be ready to go, and we can start adding templates and overriding default XCart functionality. So let's test it out. I'm just going to flip over to my XCart 5 admin area. And this is the folder that I'm working in, XC515mod. So I'm in the right admin area. And I'm just going to redeploy the store. Right now, the module does not show up. They're in alphabetical order, so we should see the module if it was enabled or installed. And we don't. We've just created the module in the directory. So we need to rebuild the cache so that we can see our new change. Okay. Okay, the cache is rebuilt, and I'm going to go back to the installed modules page. And we'll scroll down and look for our new module. Crossed fingers, right? There it is, Magnifico responsive theme. There's our description. So just that easily, we've created the base, bare bones of the theme and a module. So let's just go ahead and enable that and save changes, and it'll rebuild the cache again. Okay, so we have enabled our responsive theme. And we have a settings link here, but it's not going to take us to any settings because we haven't set any settings up. And we also have this packet link next to it. That's because I have developer mode turned on in etc/config.php. So let's visit the front side of the site. We're just going to come up here and click your storefront. And that handily opens in a new window. And we don't see any changes. It just looks like default XCart because we haven't made any changes to the templates. But this just ensures that our module has not caused any problems and appears to be working fine when enabled. Okay, so we're going to start overriding some changes and seeing some effects of our skin. And so I've already identified to you that we have the new skins Magnifico customer directory. And this is where we want to put any templates that we want to override the default templates. So any templates that already exist in default EN, we'll just put a copy or a similar named file, the same name, in customer in the same directory, and it will override default EN. But since this is also a module, we have another place that we can put our skins. And inside default EN itself, under modules, we want to create a directory here with your developer ID. Like I said, theme is a module, and you can have access both to the module's skin directory, and then also you have your custom skin directory. And the way you decide where you're going to put your template or your new change is if it's a new, like style sheet, JavaScript, or image, then you want to put that inside the default EN modules directory that we're looking at here. We're going to create a new directory here, new folder, and it's going to be named Magnifico inside our developer folder. Okay. So right in here is where we want to put our style.css, because this is the place, like I said, for new files that are being added to the XCart 5 system. If we're overriding them, we put them in the other folder. Just want to make that clear. So I'm going to right click and do a new file. And I've already got some CSS code, just very simple, to paste in here. And what this is going to do is typically we have a background that is white. So there's, you know, the page background is the same. The body background is white, and that's what sets all of this white area. So I'm going to set that to a dark color. I'm applying it to both HTML and body. And then the page wrapper, which is this portion that you know, it sticks out to about here, and it spans the entire website. That page wrapper is going to get a white color so that we don't have dark showing through all across the page. We just want to affect the background. So those are the only two styles that I have set here. So let's save the file, and we'll call it style.css. And so, you know, let's just take note, it's in default EN modules Magnifico Magnifico style.css. So now we've created our CSS file, but we need to register it with XCart. So we need to let XCart know that this file exists. And to do that, we want to come back out of our skin directory, and we want to go back up to classes. Oh, went too far. Here we go. Classes, XLite, Module, Guru, Magnifico, and we want to do a new folder. So we're going to do View. This is the View folder, which makes perfect sense that we're viewing these changes. And we're going to do a new file inside View. And again, I have prepared some code, and we're going to look it over. So here we have, you know, just the normal disclaimer. And we have our namespace. And so it's already set up. We're in XLite, Module, Guru, Magnifico, View. And I'm going to name this file AView, and so that's the class. This is just, you know, extending the default AView class from XCart 5. All right, and we have this one function, protected function, get theme files, list, parent, get theme files. So this gets all the theme files above it. And then we're adding to the list a static resource underscore CSS, modules, guru, magnifico, style.css. That's the file we just created. And then we're just returning the list, including our new file. All right, it's very simple. So we're just going to save that. And we want to call that aview.php. Make sure you get your correct capitalization there. So we pop back over to XCart Admin. And once again, we have to rebuild the cache. I want to say for a moment, you know, it seems like we're doing an awful lot of rebuilding cache. And that's mainly just because we're getting started with this project. So, you know, from this point on, if we make changes to style.css, we won't have to rebuild the cache. We'll just be able to refresh. And again, that's because I have developer mode turned on in etc/config.php. So the template files are not being cached. They're actually being refreshed in real time. So simply because we added a new template file, the style.css, and we need that to get registered with the system. That's why we have to rebuild cache at this point. But we should be good to make some changes without rebuilding cache from here on out. Okay, it's finished. And if all went well, we're going to see our gray background pop up. So we'll refresh the page, And there we have it. Okay, so let's experiment with making a change and seeing if it takes without us rebuilding the cache. So let's go back to our style.css, and I'm just going to put in a blue color as the background and try refreshing that. Oh, I put it on the wrong element, obviously. Put that on the wrapper. Don't want it there. I want it up here. Let's try that again. Perfect. All right. Okay, let's make an HTML change and start using our custom directory. Just as a simple example, I'd like to add the current page title, which would be catalog, right here, and move this section down slightly. To do this, I first need to determine what template I want to override. So I'm going to use Webmaster Kit for that. We'll go into our installed modules and we'll activate the Webmaster Kit module. Here it is. I already have it enabled, so I don't have to rebuild the cache. I can go to Settings and just turn Profile Enabled and Mark Templates. Let's go back to the front side and refresh the page. Okay, now I have this disabled tracing. And when I hover over this section, I see that it's controlled by default en category underscore description.tpl. So let's go find that template so we can make a copy of it. I'm going to go to default en and then look for category description.tpl. Here we go. All right, so I'm just going to save this as in our custom skin directory. So I'm going to come back up to skins, go into Magnifico, customer. We need a new folder for EN. We just want to completely imitate the folder structure. And we'll save this as category underscore description.tpl. Okay, so let's make a change to the file. I'm not saying this is a good change. We're just doing something to see a result. And we're going to paste this in. I had this prepared. It's just an H1 tag with the get page title call. And I already checked to make sure that function was available. So we'll just save this and we'll go back to the front side and we'll refresh. And just like that, we didn't have to rebuild cache. We didn't have to do anything besides, you know, place the new template in its directory, because this template already existed. So we're just overriding what was there before. I don't think that's a good change necessarily, because I think it might, it's just affecting the home page. So maybe that's a good thing. You want to say the word catalog on that page. No worries, you can use it for whatever you like. All right, I think I've done enough damage with this tutorial. I've been so excited to bring this to you. It's been needed for such a long time. This is Mike White with XCart Guru signing off and wishing you the best of luck in your e-commerce efforts. Till next time.